Hi guys, welcome back to The Social Tune, and today we're going to take a look at the latest release from Train, A Girl, A Bottle, A Boat.
Play that song, the one that makes me go all night long, the one that makes me think of you. That's all you gotta do.
I'll be perfectly honest with you, I have been looking forward to this album, and not because I thought it was going to be good. Many of you may remember Train from some of their older hits like Calling All Angels, or from their 2010 comeback with Hey Soul Sister, or in 2012 with Drive By and 50 Ways to Say Goodbye. Personally, I have no clue why this band was ever huge, and I have no idea why they made a comeback. But what I do know is that with their comeback, they became some of the worst songwriters around, with some absolutely insane songs under their belt. So when I say I was looking forward to this, I mean the same way you look forward to watching The Room or Troll 2. Films that are so bad that they're actually extremely enjoyable. And if the lead singles were any indication, I was bound to love this. And what I got was everything I could hope for. Now make no mistake, it's bad. It's the worst album of the year so far that I've heard. But out of all the bad albums that are going to come out this year, I doubt that I will find any of them as enjoyable as I did this. So let's kick this off with the best part of this album, the production.
Can't let this moment, slip away. Cause things like this don't happen to us every day. So take this moment and put it in a glass. If you wanna sip, I got memories on tap. Drink up, drink up.
Now, say what you will about this band, but they do have a basic understanding of hooks and melodies. However, that does not mean this album doesn't have some batshit insane moments. I'm sure most of you have heard the lead-off single Play That Song at this point, and you've heard how it interpolates heart and soul and sounds incredibly wonky and awkward. But trust me, you ain't heard nothing yet. No, if you want true insanity, take the multiple samples, multi-tracked vocals, and chipmunk voices on The News, which is simultaneously the worst song I've heard in a while and my new favorite thing. I mean, wow, it's awful. But you know what? I'll at least give it to that song that it tries. Unlike the multiple repetitive guitar patterns on Lottery. And that's before the build-up of the bongos to the chorus? What? However, even that's overshadowed by Valentine, which has a fucking a cappella choir providing most of the instrumentation and is cheesy as hell. And that's before you get to the atrocious, pitchy electric guitar plucks on the back half of that song. Then you have the way Working Girl builds up in the same way an EDM song from 2013 would, except without the drop, as it just leads into the verses, much like Iggy Azalea's Black Widow, and it's just as awkward here. Speaking of awkward, the only guest on this album is Priscilla Renea, who delivers one of the worst choruses on the album on a song that is pretty bare bones across its entirety, if I'm being honest. Also, I love horns, but the wonky ones on Silver Dollar are just ridiculous. Although to be fair, the rest of the song is pretty good. And look, the final two tracks, Lost and Found and You Better Believe, are extremely awkward, but they're easily the most genuine songs on this album, and are honestly decent. Nothing great, but I'm gonna give credit where I think it's due. But now let's address the elephant in the room, and the other reason the Train generally sucks nowadays, their lead singer.
Let me get the door for you.
Look, if you're a fan of the songs that I mentioned at the beginning of this video, that's great, but for me, Pat Monahan's singing voice is awful. It's nasal and loud in the worst possible way as he honks and squawks his way through these songs. And really, you'd think that any vocal production would be an improvement, but again, The News would prove you wrong. And if you want the best example of what he sounds like unfiltered, take Play That Song, where he's whining at people to play that song and boy, is it grating. The only part where he wasn't generally belting his lungs out was on You Better Believe. And look, he doesn't sound good, not by a long shot, but he sounds better than he does anywhere else on this album. Otherwise, once again, you have Priscilla Renea's performance on Loverman. And in all honesty, Pat Monahan sounds better on that song than she does. Which is saying something considering that on part of that song, he is literally shouting at her about how good he's going to make her feel. And again, no, I don't mean he sings loudly, I mean he shouts at her. So, bad production and terrible vocals. Do the lyrics redeem it? What do you think? You know what, I could be here for hours, so let's just skim through the highlights. Drink Up is a really cheesy opener, with a nursery rhyme flow where he says that you shouldn't regret the things you do or say, even if you do it for the fame. So is he actually encouraging gold diggers or what? Play That Song is where he hassles a DJ and a guitarist to play his girl's favorite song. And look, he won't stop bugging them, so... I mean, isn't he talking about Play That Song by Train as the song he wants them to sing? Because it's clearly playing, you're singing along to it. Otherwise, you're saying that your girlfriend's favorite song could be any song except the one I'm currently listening to. And then you have the confused mess that is the news. I mean, what the hell? There are too many great lines to count, but yeah, let's try anyway. I researched this, and as far as I can tell, Pat Monahan has never been arrested, so what is this song even about? I see in this, was it your breath or kiss? Up on my neck like this, just like you took my dying wish. Your kiss on his neck is like you took his dying wish? What? I'm coming in from your lips, tweaking from tweaking the way to your hips. He's tweaking. Did he mean twitching? Schizo from your fingertips. Schizo from your. Oh boy. They wanna see me explode upon a motor corner. I don't even know. I think that they should lock me in a rubber room and then make sure I don't hurt myself or someone else or even worse, a nurse. Are you getting me? They think that I'm crazy, but baby, this cold straight white jacket don't even faze me. So basically, this is a song about Pat Monahan going crazy. Is this song secretly genius? You know what, I've devoted enough time to this gem, on to the next one. Lottery is a song about how her love makes him feel like he won the lottery, but he doesn't seem to want to end his sentence. I want you to know that the love I have for you right now is deep and real and right and it will be. Working Girl is a track where he proclaims he's in love with a working girl. And look, the fact that he proclaims it with such bombast as if it's something revolutionary in this day and age is one thing. But the fact that he says that he's not like all those other guys who get intimidated by a woman in power, yeah, fuck you, dude. Way to throw the rest of your gender under the bus. Look, I think you get the picture. The lyrics on this album are bad. But if you want a good song here, well, lyrically Lost and Found is alright, as it's a tribute to those gone and those left behind. It's pretty generic, but it's a fair amount of fun, I have to admit. So yeah, this is a pretty bad but wildly enjoyable album. There's a part of me that wants to give this a 9 out of 10 and proclaim it as a classic, but there's another part of me that recognizes this is bad. So I'm gonna give it a very light 4 out of 10. But I highly recommend this album to all of you as a so bad it's good album. As for those of you who love this album genuinely and take it seriously, more power to you, but I'm not buying it. Still, thank you guys for watching, and if there are any other albums coming out the next month or so, please post them in the comments or tweet them at me so I can listen to them and possibly review them. You'll find a link to my Twitter in the description. Please feel free to follow me if you'd like. Please subscribe so you don't miss a thing, and until the next time, I'm Finn, and this is The Social Tune, signing off.